Thank you for volunteering to help with vision screenings. These screenings cannot happen without you, so we appreciate your time and effort. This video will introduce and review vision screening and plus lens screening for children ages 3 to 20, the steps needed to screen a student's vision, and to help you know who to contact with further questions. The team that you're working with will share additional information with you. This video is a supplement to the training you will receive from the school nurse you are working with. Always ask your school nurse if you have questions. You are never on your own. The purpose of this visual acuity screening is to test for clarity of vision when looking in the distance. You will be using either a Sloan or HOTV or LEA chart. The purpose of plus lens screening is to check for excessive farsightedness. Your school nurse will provide you with a pair of plus 2.5 plus lens glasses for this part of the screening. Here is a list of the equipment you will use for screening. Please note that there are multiple options for occluders, including glasses and handheld occluders. Light boxes are helpful to illuminate the eye charts, but not always necessary. Taping the chart to the wall is acceptable as long as you have good lighting. Step 1. Get to know your equipment. This is the equipment you will need for vision screening. You can see there is a light box and two different eye charts, Sloan and LEA or HOTV. Make sure that the light boxes are in working order and that you have enough extension cords to plug them in. There are also occluder glasses. You can see that one pair covers the left eye and the other pair covers the right eye. Handheld occluders work well for students who wear glasses and for older students. Note how they should be held to the side and not straight up and down so that the occluder doesn't press into the eye. Lastly, these are the plus lens glasses that will help screen for excessive farsightedness. Remember, plus lens screening is not necessary for students who already wear glasses or contacts. Step 2. Set up for screening and pre-teaching. Pre-teach the students the process of screening. The examiner can say, "We're going to check your eyes today. I'm going to have you put on my special sunglasses so only one eye can see. Make sure you look through the glasses and not above or turn your head to the side. Then, I'm going to point to some letters or shapes and ask you to read them one at a time. We will start at the top. Can you try for me? Great job." Let the student look at and try on the glasses. While the student is close to the chart, have them name several letters on the Sloan chart to ensure that they know them all. Remember, if the Sloan chart is too difficult, move to the LEA chart or HOTV chart. When using the LEA chart, please note that it does not matter what the student names each shape as long as they are consistent. For example, this shape can be a heart or an apple, but as long as the student calls it the same thing every time, it does not matter. Practice the matching game with the student close to the chart, then have them practice while they are seated. Have the student hold the matching chart in their lap so you can see where they are pointing. Step 3. Performing screening, Sloan. Now begin the screening. Here we will show screening with the Sloan chart. Position the child with their eyes at a 10-foot distance from the chart. Foot arches should be positioned on the 10-foot line if standing. The child's eyes should be positioned on the 10-foot line if sitting. If more than one station is used in the same area, students should be spaced 8 to 10 feet apart per MDH guidelines. There should be no other visual distractions in the area where the eye chart is presented. If the child wears corrective lenses or contacts, these should be clean and worn during the screening procedure. Position the occluder over the eyeglasses or use the occluded sunglasses if no correction is needed. The screener should point briefly beneath the letter and quickly remove the pointer. Do not visually isolate the letter or shape. Point again briefly if the student does not seem to understand the directions given. Screen the right eye first, with the left eye occluded. Starting from the top line, ask the child to identify the first letter or shape on the far right side of the chart, moving down the lines until a letter or shape is missed. Watch for peeking behaviors, such as looking above or below the occluder, turning their heads, etc. Return to the line above the missed letter or shape and ask the child to identify each letter or shape on that line, reading left to right. Use the right column for the right eye when a split occurs. If the child correctly identifies four of the five letters or shapes on the line, move down to the next line. If a line contains less than five letters or shapes, then all must be identified correctly on that line. This is the criteria used to receive credit for the line. Continue to move down the line on the right side of the chart until the child is unable to identify four out of five letters or shapes on a line. Record the results of the lowest line the child has passed after each I is completed on the sheet provided. The examiner can say, "Okay, great job. Let's switch eyes now and do it again. Then you'll be done." Allow the student to take a break between eyes to allow their occluded eye to clear. To screen the left eye, occlude the right eye. Repeat the procedure on the left side of the chart using the far left letter on each row. Use the left side column when the eye chart splits and move from left to right. Record your results. Performing screening, LEA or HOTV. Now, we will show screening with HOTV or LEA. Position the child with their eyes at a 10-foot distance from the chart. Foot arches should be positioned on the 10-foot line of standing. The child's eyes should be positioned on the 10-foot line of sitting. If more than one station is used in the same area, students should be spaced 8 to 10 feet apart per MDH guidelines. There should be no other visual distractions in the area where the eye chart is presented. If the child wears corrective lenses or contacts, these should be clean and worn during the screening procedure. Position the occluder over the eyeglasses or use the occluded sunglasses if no correction is needed. The screener should point briefly beneath the letter and quickly remove the pointer. Do not visually isolate the letter or shape. Ask the student to match each letter after pointing. Point again briefly if the student does not seem to understand the directions given. Screen the right eye first, with the left eye occluded. Start from the top line. Ask the child to identify the first letter or shape on the far right side of the chart, moving down the lines until a letter or shape is missed. Watch for peeking behaviors, such as looking above or below the occluder, turning their heads, leaning forward, etc. Return to the line above the missed letter or shape and ask the child to identify each letter or shape on that line, reading left to right. Use the right column for the right eye when a split occurs. If the child correctly identifies four of the five letters or shapes on the line, move down to the next line. If a line contains less than five letters or shapes, then all must be identified correctly on that line. This is the criteria used to receive credit for the line. Continue to move down the line on the right side of the chart until the child is unable to identify four out of five letters or shapes on a line. Record the results of the lowest line the child has passed after each I is completed on the sheet provided. The examiner can say, "Okay, great job. Let's switch eyes now and do it again. Then you'll be done." Allow the student to take a break between eyes to allow their occluded eye to clear. To screen the left eye, occlude the right eye. Repeat the procedure on the left side of the chart using the far left letter on each row. Use the left side column when the eye chart splits and move from left to right. Record your results. Plus lens screening. Lastly, you'll do the plus lens screening. Plus lens screening is easiest to do immediately after finishing with the visual acuity screening, keeping the student in the same position on the 10-foot line. Do not perform plus lens screening for students already wearing glasses or contact lenses. A pair of plus 2.5 glasses are placed over the child's eyes without occluding either eye. The examiner can say, "I have a pair of special glasses I would like you to read with. Once these are put on, then I would like you to read the line you just read on the eye chart. This time, we don't need to cover one eye at a time. Just tell me what letters or symbols you see, or if the letters or symbols look blurry." The child passes if the letters or symbols look blurry and should be referred if the letters or symbols look clear. Please note pass or refer on your recording sheet. Step 4. Recording results. Record the visual acuity for each eye as 10 over the lowest line read. Record pass or refer for the plus lens screening. This is an example of a visual acuity recording sheet. Your school nurse will have something similar for you to use. In summary, follow the steps we reviewed. Always get to know your equipment first. Set yourself up for success by making sure your environment is ready for screening and by pre-teaching your student the process of screening. Do the screening and use the tools given to help you, like the reference guide. And lastly, record your results and connect with your school nurse after screening. If you have any questions or concerns along the way, please ask your school nurse. More information can be found in the MDH Vision Manual. This training video is made possible through COVID-19 Public Health Workforce Supplemental Funding from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, administered by the Minnesota Department of Health in collaboration with BrightWorks.